So today topic is normal distribution. First of all, definition of normal distribution, that is the continuous probability distribution having the probability density function is f of x. F of x is defined by f of x is equal to sigma square root 2 pi e power minus of x minus mu whole square by 2 sigma square, where x lies between minus infinity to plus infinity and mu lies between minus infinity to plus infinity. Sigma is positive, which is known as normal distribution. So normal distribution is very most useful in the probability distribution. So that is the first one. I'll give one example, that is the measurement of error and heights of population and blood pressure and the measurement of error and IQ scores, like that. And another important one is mean and standard deviation of normal distribution. Mean mu is equal to integral minus infinity to plus infinity x into f of x, which is equal to, here f of x is the normal distribution. So normal distribution definition is 1 by sigma into square root of 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity x into e power minus of x minus mu whole square by 2 sigma square into dx. So this integration we have to simplify, that's why we have to take the substitution, put t is equal to x minus mu by root 2 into sigma, or x is equal to mu plus t into root 2 into sigma, and differentiate this one. Dx is equal to mu is the constant 0 and dt into root 2 into root 2 into sigma. So again t limits are similar, t from minus infinity to infinity. Then therefore substitute these values in the mean mu, then that is equal to 1 by sigma square root 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity. X value is x is equal to mu plus t into root 2 into sigma. And e power minus x minus mu whole square by 2 sigma square means t. So e power minus t square. And dx value also write in terms of dt's. That is dt into root 2 into sigma. So then again you have to multiply these terms and separate that one. And you had multiply and split the integration. That is root 2 into sigma mu by sigma into root 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity e power minus e power minus t square into dt, plus another one root 2 into sigma by root pi integral minus infinity to infinity into t into e power minus t square dt, which is equal to 2 mu by root pi integral 0 to infinity into e power minus t square into dt plus 0. So this is minus infinity to infinity, then we have to apply the definite integral property, that is 2 into integral 0 to infinity e power minus t square dt, plus another integral value is 0, because this function is odd function. By definite integral property, odd function of that integration value is 0, because so minus infinity to infinity t into e power minus t square dt is the odd function. That's why integral value is 0. So therefore first this value only. So this value how to solve means by using the gamma function, then simplifying, then we are getting here integral 0 to infinity e power minus t square dt is equal to root pi by 2. So then substitute that values, root pi it will be cancelled. Then simplify, after simplify we are getting mean is equal to mu only. So in normal distribution mean mu is equal to similar value. So next variance. Variance sigma square is equal to integral minus infinity to infinity x minus mu whole square into f of x dx. So x minus mu whole square into f of x. F of x is the normal distribution. Then write the normal distribution definition. 1 by sigma into square root of 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity x minus mu whole square into e power minus of x minus mu whole square by 2 sigma square into dx. Then again we have to here little bit simplification I am taking here. That is here divide and multiply by 2 sigma. So 2 sigma square. So here I am multiplying here 2 sigma square. So that's why I am multiplying and divide 2 sigma. So then this is integral minus infinity to infinity x minus mu by 2 sigma whole square e power minus of x minus mu whole square by 2 into sigma square dx. So next one I am taking substitution for solving this integration. That's why I am taking substitution. Put t is equal to x minus mu by root 2 into sigma. So then or x is equal to mu plus t into root 2 into sigma. So therefore, differentiation of this value dx is equal to dt into root 2 into sigma, where t lies between, t limits are minus infinity to infinity. So therefore, these values substitute in the integration. Therefore, variance sigma square is equal to 2 sigma square by sigma into root 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity t square into e power minus t square into dx value root 2 into sigma into dt. So simplify this one. Simplify. Then we are getting here 2 sigma square into root pi integral minus infinity to infinity t square into e power minus t square into dt. Then this integral, again we have to apply the definite integral property, that is integral minus infinity to infinity f of x dx is equal to 2 into integral 0 to infinity into f of x, like that. So therefore 2 sigma square by root pi into 2 integral 0 to infinity t square into e power minus t square dt, which is equal to 2 sigma square by root pi integral 0 to infinity t into 2t into e power minus t square into dt. Here we have to apply the integration by parts, that is integral of u v into dt is equal to integral u into integral of v dt minus integral of u dash into integral of v into dt whole dt. That is the formula for integration by parts. So here u is equal to t and v is equal to 2t into e power minus t square. So substitute that values here, then we are getting the answer is here 2 sigma square into root pi into t into minus of e power minus t square into limits of 0 to infinity minus integral 0 to infinity. So u is equal to t, t differentiation is 1. Integral of 2t into e power minus t square dt is equal to minus e power minus t square. That is, again we have to substitute the substitution method, then we are getting the answer is minus e power minus t square. So that is this. So afterwards substitute the limits, then this value is 0 plus integral 0 to infinity e power minus t square dt. So that is equal to 2 into t square root pi into this value integral 0 to infinity e power minus t square dt value is root pi by 2. So that is by gamma function. Gamma function integral 0 to infinity e power minus t square dt value is equal to root pi by 2. That value we have to write it. After simplification, then we are getting variance v sigma square is equal to sigma square. And in normal distribution, mean is equal to mu and variance is equal to sigma square. So another important note is here, standard normal variate phi of z is equal to 1 by root pi integral 0 to z e power minus z square by 2 into dz, where z from where here 0 to z. Here another one, integral minus infinity to infinity phi of z dz is equal to 1. Second one, minus infinity to 0 phi of z dz, which is equal to integral 0 to infinity phi of z dz is equal to 1 by 2. So these results equivalent from as, first one, p of minus infinity less than or equal to z less than or equal to infinity is equal to 1. Second one, p of minus infinity less than or equal to z less than or equal to 0 is equal to 1 by 2. Like that, third one, z, p of 0 less than or equal to z less than or equal to infinity or p of z greater than or equal to 0 is equal to 1 by 2. These are the, these values we have to use in while we are solving the problem. That time we have to use these results. Okay, thank you.